ஓகே. குட் மார்னிங். டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி லெக்சர் நம்பர் 2, ப்ளாக் டயக்ராம். ब्लॉक डायग्राम स्केडा, ब्लॉक डायग्राम स्केडा. द स्क्रीन इज टू बी विजिबल एनीवन?
यस सर.
ब्लॉक डायग्राम स्केडा. सो इन लास्ट क्लास इटसेल्फ आई हैव क्लियरली मेंशन द बेसिक्स ऑफ स्केडा. यू नो स्केडा मींस इट विल बी अ supervisory control and data acquisition. That is the meaning of SCADA. So the short form, the SCADA means which will be monitor the informations or monitor the informations or signals from the plant, and it will be transferred to the controller part. The person who is sitting in the station, he will can monitor the entire structure. Okay, entire structure, that is the meaning of SCADA. Now you see the block diagram of the SCADA. This is a small block diagram of SCADA. You see, there are important parts are there. The first part is RTU. RTU stands for remote terminal unit. RTU stands for remote terminal unit. And PLC. What is PLC? PLC is programmable logic controller. Okay, these are the two important parts. Okay, now in SCADA there are four major important parts are available. One is, the first part is MTU. MTU stands for Master Terminal Unit. Master Terminal Unit. What is Master Terminal Unit? It is the heart of SCADA system which can be detected a computer. The program logic control, as well as it is one of the network that communicate with remote field inside RTU. Okay, so behind RTU there will be a MTU is available. Here only the MTU is available. So this MTU, master terminal unit, which will be interconnected with the RTU. Okay, so the main function of MTU will initiates all communications, which collects the data and stores the data in a database of RTU, okay, and which provides the interface to operators, okay, as well as this master terminal unit, which allows the users, to perform controlling functions on field devices, such as breakers, switches, and other actuators depending on gathered data. Okay, gathered data. Now the second part is RTU. RTU stands for Remote Terminal Unit. Okay, the main function of RTU, which gather information from various field sites which are employed. Okay, each RTU is connected with the sensors. Okay, for example, if you take air power plant, hydropower plant, okay, if you take hydropower plant, they are monitoring air signals, that is, they are monitoring the electrical, because the hydropower plant which generates the electricity, they will monitor the voltage, current, frequency and the phase angle. So all this, each and every parameter which having the sensors to measure it. Okay, actuators is also be they are using it, because in hydropower plant there will be a water pipes are there, okay, fluid pipes are there. So to control the fluid pipes, actuator it's a switches, okay, actuators will be available. Understand Arna? So in RTU only there will be sensors and actuators are available. Are you understand my point? Are you understand? So the third portion, okay, the third part will be communication equipment. Third part is communication equipment. This communication equipment which provides the link between RTU to MTU, okay, which provides a link between RTU to MTU. Okay. This communication can be viewed by through internet, which provides a bi-directional and uninterrupted communication between RTU and MTU. Okay, as well as without communication network, internet point, we can't transfer the signals. Then the fourth one will be SCADA software. Fourth one is SCADA software. Okay, now this SCADA software, it's having, which will be connected with PLC here. This is the software they are using it. Okay, they are using it. Okay, these portions are SCADA software. Okay, what type of software they are using? One is, hello, anyone? Any doubts? There will be a PLC. Okay, PLC, it is one of the program logic controller. By using the microcontroller and microprocessor, we have to write the program depends upon the signal which we are receiving from MTU and RTU. Now, once we are return the program in PLC, now we have to process it to our computer. How to process it? There will be a fifth portion will be a data acquisition. The fifth point is data acquisition. Okay, this data acquisition, it will be process the signal, okay, which will be process the signal from analog to digital, okay, analog to digital converter, DAC, we can say DAC, D-A-Q, okay, D-A-Q stands for data acquisition. Without data acquisition, you can't transfer the signal from PLC to our personal computer. 2 hours. Personal computer. Now, from personal computer, the human should measure. So for that purpose, there will be a HMI is available. HMI. Can anyone tell me what is mean by a HMI? Anyone? Can you please tell me what is HMI?
Human machine interface.
Human machine interface. What is human machine interface? Okay, this human machine interface, it is the written in graphical programming language. Graphical programming language. Okay, and this HMI will display the information on the multiple screen. Okay, which will display the information on the multiple screen, it will be displayed, and which provides both test and synoptic diagrams. Both test and synoptic diagrams are available, because nowadays the traffic signals, everything will be monitored by the SCADA system. For example, okay, there is a hydropower plant which will be situated in Western Ghats. Okay, which will be situated in Western Ghats. Okay, but the headquarters which is available in only in Bangalore. Okay, so now the government of Bangalore should get the data. So how will get the data? They have a SCADA system. There are two SCADA systems are there. One is connected inside the hydropower plant of Western Ghats. Another one, which is main SCADA system, which is available in the headquarters in Bangalore. So the persons who is there here in headquarters, they can monitor it in one place, and the entire plant will be monitored by them. And if any problem, or if any problem will be identified, will be diagnosed, then immediately they will process the information to the higher officials to get the work done. Okay, that is the main purpose of SCADA. It is not only applicable to the power plants, it is not only applicable to the industry. Nowadays, it is applicable to the small textile factories, small scale industries also they are applying it, as well as it is applying in the hotels also they are using this SCADA system. Okay, because all the infrastructure facilities are interconnected with each other. Okay, any doubts? This is the block diagram of SCADA. So there are how many parts are there? There are six major important parts available. The first part is MTU, master terminal unit. The second part is RTU. Third part is communication network. Fourth one is SCADA software. Fifth one is data acquisition. The sixth one is HMI. Okay, HMI. Now, can you please anyone tell me? Now, if any problem is identified in SCADA. Okay, now how we can identify the particular signal, whether it is in alarm mode or otherwise it will be in a display mode. Can anyone tell me? Can anyone?
So it will be both, sir.
It will be both. Okay, usually they will operate in the first part, they will operate in alarm. Okay, alarm mode they will operate. Once we will get the alarm, then a display message will get it. A short display message will be get it. To get this alarm and display, alarm means it will be a indicators. It will be a LED indicators we will fix for each and every part. Okay, each and every part. Now, in display devices, for alarm and display devices only, they will use this graphical programming language. Now, can anyone tell me? Graphical programming language means because in your B undergraduate level, you have studied PSPICE, ARCAD capture software, MATLAB software. Now, which software will display the graphical programming language? Can anyone? Which software? Graphical programming language. Graphical programming language means it will be look like our cartoon network, Tom and Jerry. Okay, it will be in a colorful mode. That is called graphical programming language. Can anyone?
MATLAB, sir.
No, MATLAB is not a graphical programming language, because it will be a normal black and white. Okay, it is not a graphical program, because we can't interconnect this MATLAB software in real time. In real time, we can't interconnect it. It is possible to interconnect it only through data acquisition. there is one software is there to get the graphical programming language in the computer. What it is? Can anyone think? The graphical programming language costliest software is LabVIEW. LabVIEW. Have you heard about this word? LabVIEW? LabVIEW. Anyone? LabVIEW, you know? LabVIEW means Laboratory Virtual Instrumentation Engineering Workbench. Laboratory. LAB stands for laboratory. V stands for virtual. I stands for instrumentation. E stands for engineering. W stands for workbench. Any doubts in block diagram, students? Any doubts in block diagram?
No, sir.
Okay. No, sir.
Okay. Now, I will show one video. Okay. So please watch this video. This video is visible, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is a power plant. Okay, water treatment power plant. Watch this video. Are you understand? I told right, graphical program. This is nothing but graphical programming language. And here you see the indicators. Indicators you are seeing, right? These are the indicators. Okay, indicators and alarm devices will be fixed for every plant. You see how the person. RTU, remote terminal unit, it processes signal only in the binary numbers 1 and zeros only it will be sending. water is flowing through the fluid pipe, it will be reach that plant. Display right. Any doubts, students? Have any doubts?
No, sir.
Then, in SCADA, there are one is alarm processing is there, okay, alarm will be there. Then another one device which they are storing called information storage and reports. The another point will be called information storage and reports. Usually the SCADA which stores a gathered data on the either disk or permanent storage devices. The logging of the data is performed in a cyclic basis. For example, there is a weather station server. Okay, weather station server. This weather station will monitor the signal for each and every second which will monitor the signal, and it will send it to the government. Now, without sending the whatever that signals they are monitoring, it immediately they can send it. There will be a process will be there, analysis will be there. So, to analyze and process it, they will, because for every analysis there will be a methodology they will. So, by using the analysis and methodology only, they can identify whether that particular area will have a cyclone or not. Okay, cyclone or not. Okay, any doubts? Any doubts? Students, any doubts? Students?
No, sir.
Hello.
Is over, sir. Sorry, sir. Come in. Finally.